Now, a warm welcome to all of you for today's session, Evolution of Business Analytics. The Evolution of Business Analytics talk about the history of business analytics. This business analytics, it's there from the since Second World War time onwards. This business analytics there in the form of indirect. So because of the operations research and operations management, and these two all are the business analytics tools which were very frequently used in Second World War time duration. Later on, the introduction of various computer applications and various simulation algorithms and various software programs and various software applications, the decision making process through computers has been simplified. So because of nowadays we can able to take any sort of effective decision making with the help of computer programs. The best examples: Python programming, R programming, statistical package for social sciences, Stata, and all these are the various software applications which will help us to take effective decision making by applying operations research and operation management techniques. So operation research and operation management techniques, now we are familiarly using with the help of softwares. But this operations research and operations management was there from since Second World War time onwards. So it's not new nowadays. It's there from Second World War time onwards that military people use this operations management and operations research strategies very frequently in military operations. But now what we are trying to do in the sense, all this operations research and operations management techniques, we are using these techniques through or via with the help of a software, for effective decision making. So you need to understand one thing: the evolution of business analytics, it's there from since Second World War time onwards. It's not a new, and in those days the business analytics was used in indirect form from operations research and from operations management. But now we are using these all sorts of time study techniques, method study techniques, quality control techniques, linear programming, non-linear programming, and simplex method, game theories, whatnot, all these variety of different sorts of applications we are using through a particular software. So that we will get an effective decision making. We can do an effective decision making. So what are the list of such kind of softwares which will perform all these variety of operations research and operation management theories? We can perform in SPSS, statistical package for social sciences, R programming, Python, Stata, and in all these variety of softwares we can perform all this business, all these operations research or operations management related techniques. It's not new. It's a word which is there from Second World War onwards, where the very frequently used all these kind of war and OM techniques in military operations, right? And a small recap: what exactly business analytics means? It is an integrated phenomena. We required data. This data may be in the form of rows and columns. This data has to be processed. The processed data, we call it as an information. This information we are analyzing with the help of statistical tools. These statistical tools comprises of quantitative techniques, qualitative techniques, and inferential statistics and descriptive statistics, which includes numerous parametric and non-parametric tests like t-test, z-test, f-test, ANOVA, univariate analysis, multivariate analysis. So all these are our statistical tools. We are using these statistical tools with the help of a software. So where we can able to use all these kind of softwares, statistical tools in a particular software, what are those software tools? Like SPSS, R programming, Python and Stata, SAS programming, right? So all these are the variety of softwares where we can able to apply all these variety of statistical tools in a particular software. So the concept, we call it as the business analytics used for effective decision making. When we are going for effective decision making, there should be a critical problem. So when you are having a critical problem in your hand, then you are going for effective decision making. So this evolution of business analytics, the history of business analytics, it was there from time study exercise by Taylor, the time study analysis, method study analysis, operations research and operations management, management science, that's what we called MOV, and war and management science with information and communication technology. So this business analytics, it's not a new concept. It is a older concept which was there from Second World War time onwards. But in those times, this business analytics concepts used, the concepts related to OR and OM. Now we are using this business analytics with the help of a software for effective decision making, which includes all the concepts of OR and OM techniques. But the difference is now we are using with the help of a software. It's not a new, right? When you talk about the classification of business analytics, say, very clearly, I'm telling you these three concepts are very, very important. Business analytics has been classified into three types: descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics. Say, descriptive analytics uses data. To understand past and present. I will give you examples also. Prepares and analyzes historical data, identify the pattern from the past data. I will tell you one after one. Predictive analytics analyzes past performance, predicts future. Prescriptive analytics will tell you. Prescriptive analytics uses optimization techniques for effective decision making when you are having alternative choices in your hand. When you are having five different alternative choices to take an effective decision making, which one is the best decision? Will tell you about prescriptive analytics. So descriptive analytics, when it comes to the descriptive analytics, so I already told you the business analytics majorly classified into three types: descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics. Descriptive analytics will tell you about, right? It will try to study the past and present data. Suppose when we are trying to running a company, in fact, you might come across sales data. Right? This descriptive analytics will tell you, you take the sales data from past 10 to 20 years and try to infer about that particular past data. So descriptive analytics, you can describe the phenomena. How it was there from past 10 to 15 years, or else how the company sales data is there from past 10 to 20 years. In 1995, what is the sales of the company? In 2000, what is the sales of the company? In 2005, what is the sales of the company? 2010, what is the sales of the company? 2015, what is the sales? And 2020, what is the sales? You can plot with the help of bar chart, pie chart, tables. You can understand the phenomena. So descriptive analytics, which describes the phenomena, which explains the situation with the help of past data. We are not trying to predict what will happen in future. We are not going to guess what will happen in future. We are not trying to estimate. We are not trying to forecast what will happen in future, right? Descriptive analytics will tell you what was happened. What was happened? When was happened? How was happened? That's it. What was happened? When was happened? How it was happened? That's it. So descriptive analytics, which describes the phenomena, how that particular sales was happened, when that particular sales, that sales was happened, which describes the phenomena. That's it. In 1995, what is the sales? 2000, what is the sales? 2005, what is the sales? 2010, what is the sales? 15, what is the sales? 20, what is the sales? Right? This descriptive statistics won't tell you, right, what would be the sales in 2025? It won't tell you, right? It will never tell you what would be the sales in 2025. It will tell you what was happened, how it was happened, when it was happened, which just describes the phenomena with the help of charts and tables. Measures of central tendency, mean, median, mode, measures of dispersion. With the help of all these things, which describes the phenomena, what was happened, when was happened, how it was happened, what is the sales in 1995, how it was happened, what is the sales in 2000, how it was happened, 2005 sales, 2000 sales, 2015 sales, 2020 sales. That's it. Descriptive statistics, which describes the phenomena with the help of tables, graphs, charts, measures of central tendency, measures of dispersion. It will never forecast what will happen in future. Okay. Now, predictive analytics will tell you, with the help of descriptive statistics, we analyzed past performance. With the help of descriptive statistics, we analyzed past performance, how it was happened, when it was happened, where it was happened. We analyzed past performance. We analyzed with the help of bar chart, pie chart, column chart, line chart, various types of charts. Predictive analytics will tell you, if this is what the sales from past 15 years, what would be the expected sales after 5 years? what would be the expected sales of the company in 2025? What would be the expected sales of the company in 2025? So it will tell you, it will forecast what will happen in future. Need to understand very clearly. I will ask you at the end of the session. So predictive analytics will explains about what will happen in future. Predictive analytics, which will explains about what will happen in future. But whereas descriptive analytics will tell you how it was happened, when it was happened, why it was happened, right? It is all about past to present. It is all about past to present. It will give you a very clear picture. It will give you a very clear picture from past to present. Right? With the help, we are trying to analyze with the help of bar chart, pie chart, column chart, tables, measures of central tendency, mean, median, mode, measures of dispersion, quartile, standard deviation, variance. With the help of all these techniques, we are trying to analyze the phenomena. That's what we called descriptive analytics. When you go for this predictive analytics, this predictive analytics will take the help of descriptive analytics from past to present, and predictive analytics will try to estimate what will happen in future. What will happen in future? Suppose the company sales from 1995, 2000, 2005, 2010, 2015, 2020, if this is what the company sales, this is what the company sales, what would be the expected sales in 2025? What would be the expected sales in 2025? This would be explained by predictive analytics. This would be explained by predictive analytics, right? So predictive analytics, which analyzes past performance, predict future probabilities and trends, exploring relationship in data, which may not be visible directly. Which may not be visible directly. So predictive analytics, which explains the future phenomena. Now, what is prescriptive analytics? So it's very clear. Prescriptive analytics will tell you, it is an optimization tool. It is an optimization tool. It is a simulation tool. It will tell you about when you are having a group of alternatives in your hand. When you are having a group of alternatives in your hand, which would be the best alternative to take it as a decision? Which would be the best alternative to take it as a decision? We call it as the concept of prescriptive analytics. So prescriptive analytics, it is an optimization technique which will be useful for taking an effective decision making from group of alternatives. From group of alternatives. When you are having a group of alternatives in your hand, right? Which would be the best alternative and which would be the effective decision making that we can able to take in this contemporary scenario, which speaks about the prescriptive analytics. The prescriptive analytics. So the classification of business analytics majorly classified into three types. We call them as descriptive analytics, predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics. The descriptive analytics, which measures the data from past to present with the help of various types of charts like bar chart, pie chart, line chart, dollar chart, trend lines. With the help of various types of charts, we are trying to measure the past to present data, and at the same time we will take the help of measures of central tendency, mean, median, mode, that can be calculated, and quartile deviation. With the help of this one also, that we can able to describe the phenomena, right? Predictive analytics majorly calculated with the help of multiple linear regression analysis. In fact, the